Okay. Cora's in here.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
They'll be starting crops soon. Can't tell if they have enough water or too much. I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids. But I always loved them. I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
It'd be good to bring something beautiful across galaxies.
Everyone in the initiative has their something beautiful. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go.
Why?
The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
It sounds like she cared more about what you needed than about what you wanted.
I didn't need to be rejected. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder. Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place, even AI, or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me that's okay?
He gave you a dream to work toward. He was good at that.
Who doesn't want to belong? Especially somewhere like the Initiative. So I gave the Initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted.
She wants a rose garden. That's so adorable.
I thought I knew what I was going to be.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
I get that. We've all had a lot of disappointments lately.
You're doing well. For having no training, being your second isn't so bad.
Thanks.
If that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses too.
Okay. Alright, so we're starting to
get
along.
Again?
Oh yeah.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
Will we be able to actually find them?
I'll be here.
Because otherwise it kind of defeats my purpose of being a Pathfinder, I guess. If somebody else can come and all the other Pathfinders can take over my job or something. We have plants in here now. That's pretty. That's really pretty. It's not exactly a garden, but you know, it's close. Who's supposed to be in here? What is it? This is our research area, right? Like the tech lab? Yeah. Who do we have left? We have Jaw, I think.
Those remnant vaults, all those secrets. I have to go exploring in one someday.
Imagine flying through one. Now that would be a real hazard course.
I think Peebee said she's in one of these areas, but I'll talk to these guys for my email.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd. But I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
So your two options are heck yes or heck no. No, I don't want to. I'm not going to, like, rain on her parade.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe. Wow. It's wonderful to
understand. She shouldn't have to justify herself. It's all good.
I've had to justify myself so often.
It's all good.
As if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if the secret could be diminished by the search for truth.
Yeah, you don't have to justify it.
I wasn't questioning your abilities. You never have to justify yourself to me.
Thank you. I appreciate you saying that, truly. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Yeah. For sure, for sure. I'll chat with y'all whenever you want.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
I feel like I should worry about it if my engineer and my pilot aren't getting along.
What can I do for you?
There needs to be trust there, you know?
I couldn't help overhearing you and Gil. Sounded pretty heated.
He likes redesigning things, but the ship was built this way for a reason. I wish Gil would respect that. It's nothing to concern yourself about, really.
That's gonna have to be addressed at some point.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
I'm not.
No, I'm not falling for that again.
I'm not falling. What? Okay.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
I like Callow. He's funny. Everybody's so funny. Everybody's just a funny, happy time. Can I fall off? No, I can't. I have to take the ladder animation. I'm wearing gloves, too. Jeez. Bathroom. Anybody in the bed? Oh, wait, no. Wait, I gotta go back. I gotta talk to Peebee. Oh, my Pajak! I gotta go say hi to my Pajak, too. You making trouble, Pajak? Airlock. She's not in the airlock, but I'm just gonna... Okay. She's in the escape pod.
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault.
Wow, how'd you carry that here?
If I can track this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Should I consider you a temporary addition?
Everything's temporary, Ryder. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to...
Oh my gosh!
I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
We'll be flirty.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
Haha.
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun.
What?
Did I say that out loud?
Did I say
life won't be boring with you around.
Oh, okay.
I'm never yawn again.
So flirting doesn't take away either of these. Okay, I thought maybe you only could, like, do one or the other. Okay, that's good.
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
She sounds very passionate about that.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Find me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again... I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. for projects like the one I mentioned, which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Okay. Remtech, huh? You got it.
Do I have any? What are you doing? You look very, very hunched over. What if there's an emergency and everyone goes piling through here, you know what I mean?
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Yes.
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
What?
Not much at all.
That was very forward.
I get a little extra jolt when I matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
Oh, okay.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone. That was very forward.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
So, how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Betra. Not your typical military-minded Turian.
Yeah.
Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drack is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
I wonder how old she is.
What about
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callow and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right. Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
That's just... It's casual, so I don't think it's actually rude, but...
She's exactly what she should be. Capable, reliable. She's a valuable part of my team.
Sure, sure. That comes across, too.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
Okay.
What drew you to the Remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
Okay.
You're off the hook, Peebee. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. You're off the hook.
Don't be a stranger.
You don't be a stranger. You're the one being a stranger. Well, excuse me. Let me just back right up on you. Jeez. All right. That was Peebee. Drack's in my kitchen. Drack, I really don't know how I feel about you just hanging out in the kitchen. I think you're too big to be in the kitchen. I think you're too big to fit on any of the bunks, too, but... Oh, shoot. What?
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Roshan.
Oh, that was
so
Kesh.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Aww.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh, someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tan. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Your people had to know what it'd be like when you left the Nexus.
We did, but there weren't a lot of options. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony.
This is a horrible way to start things with the Krogan.
Bad consequences all around.
Are we already trying to alienate the Krogan? You know what I mean? Like, we want to start what happened in the Milky Way galaxy all over again? Like,
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Where are the rest of your people? Are you my new chef?
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around.
I don't think so.
Spender lied to the Krogan during the
uprising. Oh, yes.
He's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
Okay.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station.
They should have had a say anyway from
Spender,
the start.
Addison's assistant lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
More like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out if my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
Okay.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Why are we asking about Sam?
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost.
Hmm.
Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head, and it ain't messing with my body.
I'd like to know more about you.
That was a bit aggressive.
Fire away.
Oh,
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit.
She is pretty awesome.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable. The
what
works.
What planet?
Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years.
Jeez!
don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
It ain't luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
War stories.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a piejack scratch its butt?
Anything about the cat? Or combat in general?
Good question.
Well, common cat are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
More.
Tell me more about fighting cat.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like the ghost up behind you. Haven't fought a wraith yet, I don't think. Expected. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you. Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Tell me more about fighting cat.
Destined or annoying. Quick. Got some crazy mist that hides them from view. Their friends, too. Take a destined down, and that mist goes away. Makes them a prime target, if you ask me. Perfect for grenade practice.
Oh, okay.
Tell me more about fighting Ket.
There's just something wrong about the Ket. The absolute single-mindedness.
Okay.
Tell me more about fighting
Ket. This is getting awkward.
So, Chosen, it's not good to let too many of them get close to you at once. If they hit your shields, take a step back. Let me handle them. Bet you anything they're not used to being rushed by a Krogan.
Okay. This is getting awkward.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
I think it's cute. I like it. Okay, is this my room? Oh, hey, Drack, keep me safe. Oh, my piejack! I'm my piejack!
Hey, there you are.
Oh.
Check your helmet before you put it on. This scratch? He was sleeping in mine.
Gross. How did she... She's on the other side of the ship. That's a little weird. Where'd my music go? I like my jams. Where... I really like the subharmonica one. This looks like a treadmill. What else do I have? Oh, my helmet. Piejack. Piejack, baby. You think this is... You like the jam? You like my jams? I've got... what? This looks like face wash. I know it's probably supposed to be alcohol, but it looks like face wash. And initiative cards. Nice. Sam, how's it going, Sam?
Hello, Ryder. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Well, thanks. Okay.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
All right. Wow. Forgive the intrusion from Eridania. I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to readily solve. It may assist my investigations into the Scourge. We can discuss it in person at the Nexus Labs. My regards to you and Sam. Thank you. Brothers McCoy. My brother Dash was my best friend and still pains me he's gone. We won't build a future here in drama together, but knowing our family pendants are united does my heart good. My wife and I settled down here and start a family. Our firstborn will carry my brother's name and hopefully he or she will become my new best friend. Alright, guy. Reminder. Thanks for talking. Things feel better, though they don't feel fixed yet. Remember to take time for yourself, too. Work's important, but so is time to grieve. Grief and fear cannot rule you. Let them be your faithful servants, protective of their mistress. Loss serves a huntress like fuel serves fire. Estheris, 12 leaves versus 130. Wow, thank you! That was really sweet of her! Plants are coming along. Sam and I are learning about botany together. Interesting times. Well, cute! I'm gonna, like, get teary-eyed! From Cora, can still smell that remnant vault on my armor. A lot of weird crap down there, like my Huntress manuals would say. The razor's edge between known and unknown teaches you what can be cut away. Now I think back, it reminded me a little bit of some of the temples on Thessia. Some same huge spaces and running water. Same sense of a huge purpose you can't really understand. Makes me wonder if we'll ever really know what their builders did there. Tempest Hex? What? From Callow. I'm pleased to report the Tempest is operating at peak efficiency, so now that you're in command, I thought I'd share a few secret shipboard hacks that the designers and I stayed under her code. Just send the code JCSB through your Omni tool to open the debug command menu. Give all dispense. Let's use the coffee dispenser in the galley at unlimited. Wait. Number of times. Water temp override overrides the normal hot water ration in the showers. Jump wash queue puts your clothing ahead of everyone else's in the auto laundry cycle. Enjoy and don't share them around. Thanks, Callow. Proud to be here. It's from Liam. Hey, Pathfinder, just hitting this point again. Our team, no place I'd rather be. Here's where we get to fix things. As soon as we have people on the ground, I'll have eyes on how to get them what they need. This sort of just make it happen is why I joined the hustle and exactly why I came here. We'll do it. Liam has included a list of media themed to frontiers. Genres include Western, space opera, and oddly, Turian historical dramas. Jeez! Liam is very eager! From Vetra, Pathfinder, I thought I had to clarify. I noticed something about back channels, doing what I have to do, being on the Nexus during the bad times. A lot of us got used to ugly things, because survival just isn't that pretty. But in the end, I'm here to help you, so if there's anything you don't like, I won't do it. Simple as that. Okay. Spirituality. Oh, I'm so glad for our chat earlier. I've had to defend what I believe so often, I have to admit I'm a little tired of it. Whenever I meet someone who feels the same or just understands, I really appreciate it, so thank you. Aw, thanks. From Drack. Vetra told me about what happened to your dad. I've lost a lot of people over the years. Figured you should use some cheering up, or at least a distraction. This usually helps me. Drack has attached 37 images of various rifles and shotguns. Two are duplicate images. Many are low res or watermark. Oh, Drack! I've got, like, tears in my eyes. That's so sweet. To Ryder from Lexi. Ryder, attaches my Croker thesis I mentioned to you. I know only 500 pages, but wasn't allowed to go over. If you get through, I wrote a longer dissertation for the Citadel Journal of Medicine. Around 1,400 pages, that's much more insightful, includes mating diagrams. Why do they taunt me with Krogan romance and, Lexi, jeez. Ryder, given the amount of high-impact cardio and exercise routine, I recommend spending 5 to 10 minutes a day stretching to open your hips and relieve tightness in the lower back. The poses I listed should do nicely, not to sound elite, but while it's true humans invented yoga, the Asari perfected it. This is from the doctor. Oh, okay. Turning 1 foot, take a deep breath. Matriarch Tavira's embrace. Matriarch's pose. Please let me know. Well, that was really nice of her. Jeez, that was really nice. I've attached my paper on the Helios server. Oh, did we already read that? Pajay. Yeah, okay. Well, dang. Okay. Wardrobe. Nope, I think we're good. I wish I could do yoga. Why isn't yoga an option? Can I go to sleep? I can't go to sleep. Okay. Drack. Let's try to sneak up on somebody, maybe. Oh, right. The crew info board. Lost and found. Found a mug yesterday near the bio lab. Nice with a magnetized base. You left it stuck sideways to a bulkhead, Cora. That's mine. I just put it down for a sec when my hands were full. Suvi. Next time, maybe empty it first, Cora. Drack and PBR are officially on the team. Finished the assignment paperwork on the Pit Nexus. Had to fudge a few details, but you're both officially members of the Pathfinder team. Welcome. And Drack, I just wanted to check in publicly about what I said. Relax, Harper. The best headbutt is always the one you don't see coming. Drack, I'll keep that in mind, Cora. Yep. Okay. Okie dokie. Wait. Bathrooms are split into boy-girl. Really? In the future day and age when who knows what anybody's gender is at all, in anything, way, shape, or form, we're gonna have male-female signs on the bathroom? Oh yeah, I was like, where's the doctor? But she's not here right now. She's upstairs. Crew quarters, okay. Ooh, there's my nomad. Oh, Oh, hey, you're out here now. All right, so you're not going to be stuck in that little room.
Feels like early brain surgery. Just poking and hoping.
What are you doing?
As long as it helps us to live here, I don't care how the vault's doing it.
I prefer tech with more exposed bolts. If you can't open it, you don't own it.
Are you all just, like, on, like, a single frequency or something?
Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
I mean, wow, okay, just, no, let's just be chill.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. Your Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
That's excessive. It's like...
We'll talk later.
Where's the subtlety?
I know.
I like Liam, but I don't know if I like him that much to be like, hey, date me. He's got, like, a TV set up. I mean, it's nice for everybody to have their own space, but, I mean, we might as well just not have dorm rooms. Petra! Oh, she's just chilling over here.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone. Blah.
I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
Hey!
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Sid.
No, just me and Sid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special?
Oh. Oh, wow, this is so awkward!
Oh. No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
Where's my brother?
Oh, romantic. I wasn't expecting that. And again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic. Anyway.
You Bye. Probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Wow, he just does not make any bones about that, you know? It's just like, hey, what's up? But it's just so funny, she's got like sweets in here. I think that's so funny. So funny. So funny! Oh, I had to call it down. I was like, what? Gil, I haven't forgotten you. Please be nice to my pilot. You're a hilarious dude, but I could tell from the moment I met you that you used humor to deflect more serious issues. Where you at, Gil? Were you downstairs where I didn't see you? Let's see. Where are you? Oh. Just out this way? Oh, hey, buddy.
Hey, Ryder. What's the story?
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. Peebee's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drack's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go... Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo?
Oh, yeah, I did that before.
Ooh, can I be a...
Okay, so that was different.
He's a pilot.
Which means...
He flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Bye!
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
So if I asked everybody else about the crew, would they change what they said?